Hello everyone. We're going to be talking about Disney today, and it's at 196.46 right now, and it's a great stock, great company. Basically, they're on the NYSE. They're a $359 billion market cap, which makes them a large cap stock. They're also a member of the Dow Industrials and the S&P 500, and they're in the communications sector, and within that sector, they're in the media industry. And we have some other information right here. Let's go right into the chart though. So here's the 1 year chart. And let me just point out that number one, it's got a 92% return over this last 12 months, which is incredible. And these white vertical lines are earnings dates. Earnings dates are basically the company's report card that comes out every 3 months. So going into each earnings and after each earnings, I think it's really important to look at the price action. And as you can see though, overall the trend has definitely been up. And then specifically here on this earnings date here, the price was above both moving averages, and then it just kind of kept staying above the 50-day, well, both of them, but the 50-day in particular. And then right here it kind of spiked a little bit. And typically what I've noticed is when the price of any stock, usually, or ETF for that matter, when it spikes too far above or even below, it tends to kind of either go sideways or will come back down closer to the moving averages. In this situation, the price kind of went sideways, a little bit up, it kind of just moved sideways, and then it touched the 50-day moving average here, and then went on a little bit of a pre-earnings run into this earnings date, and then it sold off a little bit. Then it's kind of had a little bit of ups and downs, but it's definitely on this uptrend. And by the way, these are all new 52-week highs and all-time highs. And it's very bullish for a stock to be hitting 52-week highs and, more importantly, all-time highs, because that means that there's just so much buying interest that the stock just, there's more buyers than sellers, and they think the company's doing better than it's ever has over the course of a 52-week period, or even since it went public. So that's what we have here. And let's just look at the 5-year chart real quick. So the first few first 2, 3 years here, we were kind of going sideways, but then we started to move higher. And then we got into the pandemic, and then it dropped significantly. But then once it bottomed out, it just started to take off. And then this is the really that 1 year chart you're seeing here. And as you can see, it's like really high, like 52-week high, all-time high levels right now. So if this type of a chart looks good to you, then I just definitely recommend checking out this all-time highs channel. You can just click on this link here, which is the date of the all-time high for Disney. So we're going to click on that, go over to this. It's a Prime channel, and basically you can click on any date in the past, and you'll see the symbols that had an all-time high on that date. But for example, Disney was March 8th, and there's 20 of them that were on March 8th. So let's see what we have here. Oh, and then also, the symbols are sorted by default, market cap descending. You can sort by other factors, but here's the first one is Disney, which we were talking about. And by the way, when a company hits an all-time high and the price is kind of just above the moving average, but just a little bit above, and it's like the trend is your friend. And as long as it just stays in that nice sweet spot distance, I guess, above the moving average, there's no reason to sell. Of course, just monitor the earnings dates as they come up. But let's look at a couple other all-time highs from March 8th and see what those charts look like. So here we have American Express. So they have a 49% return, and the moving averages crossed here. It went up. We had an earnings here. It dipped, and then it took off a little bit. So this is an example of it. American Express is another great company, but the stock price did, it's significantly far away from the 50-day moving average. So this might be a situation where it might go sideways or might pull back a little bit just for profit taking. Let's look at another one. HCA Holding, 80% return. This is an all-time high. So these are all like all-time highs, and you can see that there's excitement and more bullishness on stocks that are hitting all-time highs. Let's look at one more. Emerson Electric, so 82% return. And, you know, this is another great company. So for a trade, what I really look for is the price going above the moving averages and an earnings, and then seeing that earnings response right after the earnings, 2-3 days after the earnings. That's a good buy or entry point. And you just kind of like watch it, make sure it stays kind of close to the above, but close to the 50-day moving average as you move forward. And sometimes you get a nice little run there, or, you know, and then we have another earnings date, and these are all just all-time highs. So let's do one more. Let's see what we have. Okay, we have one more here, another 88% return. And so I just wanted to show this is a, there's a, like I said, there's a bunch of them on here. And you can look at, let's see. So yeah, so Monday, March 8th, there was 20, but on March 9th, there's 16, on March 10th, there's 42. So if you're interested in finding more stocks that look like Disney, I invite you to check out this All Time Highs channel on Symbol Surfing. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching.